Hey, Mimir. Last we were in a boat, you had just started the story. What did you want to tell me about the Long War?
Prior to that, wars for Aesir were easily won. But the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
You want a beach here? It's like there was an entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
I forgot.
Take him down together.
Almost there!
Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes?
You mention it.
Told you. You should come back with a cipher. These are the ones I can't read. I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. And we'll pick this up later.
What's hiding behind there?
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
Seen a lock like that before.
Reminds me of something I've seen Tyr sketch. He liked to combine various symbols into runes all his own. This one, I believe, means
peace, unity, mercy, other things too. I see what he did, but how do we get inside?
We have other concerns.
We're not getting in there without a key.
Huh.
You were saying something about love and hate being...
intertwined, yes. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Fjorgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Fjorgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counsellor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Another name. Gerdrifol.
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Yes, sir!
Oh!
there. Okay. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. And we'll pick this up later.
For more like this. Telling us how Frey ended up living in the woods.
Aye, she'd married Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. And we'll pick this up later.
Ulfric. You were taken from this realm too.
Among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father? Maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out...
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand.
Thank you.
This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thangor. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky. Yes, a very, very giant chisel.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Neat trick, lad.
Thanks.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Huh.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles. What should we do? Crystal.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. So Njord, the Alpha, backed the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Behind you!
Can we go through?
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. Let's get started then.
Anything you need, young sir.
The bow.
Something else for you then? Yes, dear boy. steel. Be seeing ya.
Plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward?
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No. Prepare yourself!
The hang of this. Come here. You knew this place? before?
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What
is
the difference between the war between the gods?
Nothing at all. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
Another crystal. Just give the word.
Stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do?
Come on!
What we need is all the way down there.
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
How are we going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip?
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck, then?
You are welcome to suggest a different one. Tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet head. Jump!
That didn't work. It only fell a little ways.
Thank you.
The floor's collapsed. There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song I used to sing.
Do I know that one? Winter like...
Quiet, Head.
He doesn't like music either. Got it.
Vetter. House. Vetter. Vetter. Still nothing.
Boy, the order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Boy.
Vetter. House. Vetter. Vetter.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed.
There you go, brother.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Do it.
Vetter. Haust. Sumar. Vetter. No.
Want me to...
No. I just need quiet. Winter. Last.
You sure you...
Quiet. Winter is last. Retrograde. Try that.
Haust. Vaur. Sumar. Vetter.
Once more, boy. The song.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
When reversed, winter is last.
And autumn first.
I know.
Oh, I know, brother. Just reminding you what you know, you know.
There.
Vaur. Haust. Sumar. Vetter. I don't think we're ever going to get this.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn. But reversed. Autumn first. Winter last. There.
House. Sumar. Vaur. Vetter. Yes.
Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing. Head, how is this possible?
My guess, temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
To the bow.
Keep it up. Back to writing, before the floor collapses.
Thola. Thola.
Yeah!
Almost down to nothing.